Alright, okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and good afternoon to everyone. Welcome to our webinar series in February 2021. I'm Nur Azliza Ahmad from Faculty of Engineering and Built Environment. I would like to share with all of you guys, okay, for your information, our Faculty of Engineering and Built Environment have 5 departments. We have Electrical and Electronics Engineering Department, Civil Engineering Department, Mechanical Engineering Department, Quantitative Survey Department, and also Architecture Department. So we have a diploma and degree program for each. Alright, so it's a great pleasure for me to introduce our speaker today, who is going to talk us about the nanomaterials for renewable energy. This is a subject which we should all be deeply interested in, because nowadays in 2021, we look forward into sustainability and green technology with Industrial Revolution 4.0. Therefore, our speaker today will share with her experiences on nanomaterials with a renewable energy application, which is a part in a current demand right now. Okay, so our speaker today is actually born from Malang, Indonesia. So, and also she's graduated from State of University Malang, Indonesia for the bachelor degree and further the study for the master in the Bandung Institute of Technology. And for the PhD level, she's having in University Technology Petronas, Malaysia. So, although having spent almost her entire research area in nanomaterials, not only in her country, which is in Indonesia, she also having collaboration with all the countries such as Malaysia and also New Zealand. So, she is an award-winning of a best lecturer in State University of Malang, Indonesia, and several awards such as gold medal in her research expertise. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, actually, they have a Q&A session to all of you guys. If you have any inquiries regarding nanomaterials for renewable energy, so you may write down anything that if you have any question, any inquiries happening, and then we will go back into after finish our session. All right. So ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, please join me in welcome Associate Prof. Dr. Poppy Puspitasari to our webinar series. Welcome, Prof. Poppy.
Okay, assalamualaikum and a very good afternoon to you all. First of all, I would like to thank Mrs. Nur Azliza Ahmad and especially Masa University for the opportunity that given to me for this event in this webinar series that conducting by Masa University. So the topic today is about the nanomaterials for renewable energy. And let me introduce myself. My name is Poppy Puspitasari. I'm working in the Mechanical Engineering Department, Engineering Faculty, Universitas Negeri Malang or State University of Malang, Indonesia. You can contact me at poppy@um.ac.id. So these are the outline of my presentation. First is about the Universitas Negeri Malang, and then about the Center of Advanced Materials and Renewable Energy, or we used to call it CEMRI, and then the nanomaterials and its application, and last but not least about the research experiences. So any of you wondering where is Malang take place? Malang is a name of city. Yes, it's not a set person or maybe set city. Malang actually located in East Java. So if you are looking at the Indonesia map here, so Malang is in East Java with the capital city of Surabaya. And Malang is about 1.5 until 2 hours drive by car from Surabaya to Malang here. And Universitas Negeri Malang or State University of Malang is in the center of Malang City. Actually, Mrs. Azliza have been visiting Malang 3 years ago, if I'm not mistaken. Yes.
Yes. If you are wondering if we end of the MCOs that we can go again to Surabaya later on?
Of course. I'm waiting for you and your family also with Masa University colleague. Please welcome.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, so this our student body. We have Universitas Negeri Malang have 9 faculties and also 31 departments and then 1,063 lecturers and also around 28,000 students. So actually mechanical engineering department and also engineering faculty located in the main campus, which is the first campus of Universitas Negeri Malang. We have 3 campus, and then the first campus is the main campus. So actually we located in this building, actually H4 to H5 building for the engineering faculty. And then we move on to the Center of Excellence in Universitas Negeri Malang. We have 2 Center of Excellence. One of them is the Center of Advanced Materials and Renewable Energy, or CAMRI. In CAMRI, we have 4 main topic area of research: the solar cell, biomass, storage material, and the smart grid. So this is the milestone of CAMRI. Until 2030, we have to do the commercialization of the product, which we have used the nanomaterials for all of the research topic here. So basically, my research area is in this harvesting energy device under the solar cell, and then for the biomass, the collaboration between my colleague and me in renewable energy with the local material and also the waste material for the renewable energy. And then my research itself about the storage material in the supercapacitor and also the exploration of a new material for the renewable energy. So to achieve the this milestone, we need the collaboration between internal research partner from the other university in Indonesia and also from the research center in Indonesia, and also the collaboration between the external partner research from the abroad. Actually, we have Indonesian-Malaysian collaboration research, IMRC, in our university. So we have collaborated with some university in Malaysia and one university in New Zealand under Professor Timotius Pasang in Auckland University of Technology. In CAMRI, we have to supervise the student from the bachelor, master, and doctoral degree to help our research and also help student to finish their study by using the grant or funding and also our research equipment and facility. So these are some of the facilities in our campus for the nanomaterial. We have XRD and then SRF, SEM for the morphology, GPR, GCMS, FTIR. And by this year, we have a single X-ray diffraction and also low temperature PPMS. So let me have refresh or maybe remind you about the nanotechnology. Nanotechnology itself is a science, engineering, and technology that conducted in a nanoscale size, which is 1 until 100 nanometer. Nano itself refers to the technology or the materials or the particles and objects that are focusing at the workplace that we use more widely today. For example, a sheet of paper is about 100,000 nanometer thick, or the human hair is around 80,000 nanometer wide, and also the viruses in the several hundred nanometers. Nanomaterials itself can be occur naturally, can be found naturally in our environment, and also can be found incidentally from the human. And the last thing is we can engineer nanomaterials. So this engineered nanomaterials that we use for the research in renewable energy. So this is the form of the nanomaterials in a powder form for the metals and also the buckyball for the carbon, and then the nanotubes and also nanocapsules or encapsulation nanomaterial. The synthesis of nanomaterials divided into 2 main parts, which is top-down and bottom-up synthesis. For the top-down synthesis, For example, solid state reaction, we use the ball milling process and also nanolithography and also the chips and processor. And the bottom-up synthesis, we can do the sol gel, self-combustion, co-precipitation, or chemical vapor deposition, and many synthesis done by bottom-up synthesis. Okay, the nanostructure itself divided into, I think, 3 to 4 category here. There is a cluster, nanocrystal, and quantum dot with the radius of 1 until 10 nanometers. And then the nanowires and nanotube with the diameter 1 until 100 nanometer. Each of the structure has the application in this industrial, which is for semiconductor, and then for the insulator, and also for the catalyst. It depends on the structure of the nanomaterial itself. So if we talk about the properties of nanomaterial, in the form of the catalyst material, in the catalytic properties, it will get the catalytic efficiency through the higher surface to volume ratio. And then for the electrical properties, it will increase the conductivity of electrical. And also for the magnetic properties, it will increase the coercivity and the superparamagnetic behavior. And for the mechanical properties, we can improve the hardness and toughness of metals and alloy. And then for the optical properties, it can increase the fluorescent properties and also increase the quantum efficiency. For the sterical properties, we can increase selectivity. And from the biological, we can increase the biocompatibility properties. So these are the application of nanomaterial, and we are focusing on the renewable energy for today. If we look at this application, there are so many applications if we use the nanomaterials and also the nanoparticles. So I think we're just focusing on this one, the renewable energy. The nanomaterials in energy sector, actually, we can find in our home, or we can apply it in our home and our environment, or even in campus. We can use it as energy conversion, energy generation, energy saving, energy transmission, and energy storage. So nanotechnology itself in the energy sector, mostly in the wind turbines and also in the batteries or supercapacitor, used in our research project in Universitas Negeri Malang. And also, in fact, there is one building, we built one building or using green technology, and we use the solar cell for the energy application, nanomaterial application in the energy sector in our campus. So why are nanomaterials used? For the first reason is that materials property can be changed by the synthesizing, by the engineer nanomaterials. There are the melting point, fluorescent, electrical conductivity, or maybe the coercivity. We can change the properties by using the nanomaterials. And the second reason is that nanomaterial has large surface area. What does it mean by large surface area? The large surface area, it means that the materials have a contact with the surrounding materials and will increase the reactivity of the surface area. So that's why nanomaterials is very important, and we use in the many application, and especially in the renewable energy. So let's jump to the research experiences. So from 2008 until 2017, my main research focusing in the synthesizing and the characterizing of the oxide and magnetic materials. I have synthesized the zinc oxide, manganese oxide, iron oxide, and also manganese zinc ferrite, nickel zinc ferrite, yttrium iron garnet. Back when I'm doing my PhD, I used this material for the ammonia production catalyst. And then when I'm joined back to Universitas Negeri Malang, I do the collaboration with my colleague. So in 2018, we have a research about the solid fuel catalyst using the nanomaterials that I have been synthesized. And then at 2019, we do the nanofluid for heat exchanger project. And then for 2020, we do the nanomaterials for biodiesel catalyst. And then from 2021, we do the nanomaterials for solar flat plate collector and also the application in the supercapacitor. So this is our team. Associate Professor Dr. Sukarni is the leader on the solid and liquid fuel using the nanomaterials as the catalyst. And Mrs. Avita Ayu is the leader on the heat exchanger and solar flat plate collector using the nanomaterials in nanoflip. So let's jump to the first research that I will discuss with you all. This is the nanomaterial for heat exchanger. What is heat exchanger actually? Heat exchanger is the tools that transfer heat from one medium to another. One type that we use in our lab is the shell and tube heat exchanger, which is consists of a large number of small tubes and located within a cylindrical cell. So we built a mini heat exchanger like this. This mini heat exchanger consists of the shell and tube inside of the cylindrical, and then there is a hot fluid and the nano fluid and different tank, and also the valve, so we can control the flow of the hot fluids and also control the flow of the nano fluids. So the first research that I conduct, I use the nickel oxide. This is with Mrs. Avita Ayu. So I use nickel oxide for the nano fluid. First of all, I have to synthesize the nickel oxide using the sol gel method and self-combustion method. And then we compare the result in a heat exchanger between the condition of nickel oxide before sintering process and after the sintering process, and we compare with the distilled water as nanofluid. So this is the properties, the thermophysical properties of nickel oxide and also the nanofluids. The nanofluid itself is the mixture between the water, the distilled water, and the nanoparticle of nickel oxide. So as we see here, that the heat transfer is better when we use the nanofluid from the nickel oxide and the distilled water, comparing with the aqueous itself. So the next research conducting by Mrs. Avita, she used the titanium dioxide for the heat exchanger. And we see here, this is a thermophysical properties of titanium dioxide and also thermophysical properties of ethylene glycol that become the mixture of the nanofluid later on. And then the morphological of titanium dioxide we see here, and the phase identification of titanium dioxide, a single phase of titanium dioxide that later on will be mixed with the ethylene glycol. From the result of this titanium dioxide for the heat exchanger, we can see that the Reynolds number and Nusselt number is become increasing, and also the delta TLMTD and the heat transfer also increasing. So what does it mean? It means that the heat transfer or heat exchanger doesn't need much energy, or it's slower the energy to do the heat transfer process from the heating to cooling process in the heat exchanger itself. Both previously project using the oxide material, and this one is using the magnetic material. We use the manganese ferrite. We do the mixture with the nanofluid, and then we flow to the heat exchanger, and the result shows that even the manganese ferrite or magnetic nanomaterial here is better than oxide material, the previous oxide material, that we see the heat transfer also increasing, and the energy need for the heat transfer process in the heat exchanger also become lower. This one is the project led by Dr. Sukarni using the nanomaterial that I have been synthesis before. He used the titanium dioxide for the catalyst in microalga pyrolysis. So the microalga that he used is the Tetracellulose tree. From the TG and DTG result here, we can see that at the first stage, there is a decrease in the temperature for 3 until 4 degrees Celsius. And then at the final stage here, there is a decrease in the temperature between 4 until 8 degrees Celsius in order. It means that the catalytic activity is quite good here for the pyrolysis compared to the microalga itself without the catalyst titanium dioxide. So this is the last research that I share with you. So I do the nanomaterials for high cycle supercapacitor, and it's still an ongoing project. This is a second year project using the cobalt oxide, cobalt ferrite, and also the nickel cobalt for the supercapacitor. So we have been synthesized and characterized those material, and then we will try to compare the ability of those material on the supercapacitor and the cyclic, also using the current and voltage curve later on. But from the previous research, we can see that cobalt oxide has a good capability as a supercapacitor in the scan rate of 10 to 400 millivolt per second. So these are our collaborators, Professor Dr. Timotius Pasang from AUT, and then Professor Dr. Hadi Nur from UTM, Professor Dr. Nurani Muti from UTP, Associate Professor Dr. Maizatul Shima Saharun from UTP, Dr. Siti Nur Azela binti Zain from UTP, Dr. Technologist Jeffrey Abdul Razak from UTEM, Dr. Syekh Muhammad Syahrul Nizan Syahari from USIM, and then next I will waiting for Mrs. Nur Azliza Ahmad for any of the Klik and Mahsa University to collaborate with me and Universitas Negeri Malang, of course.
Yeah, sure, because right now we are going to have sustainability and green technology towards the Industrial Revolution 4.0. The nanomaterial actually yes. A part of this, yes.
Yeah, so actually this is the initiation, right, Ms.
Aziza? Yes, because this is the beginning. The beginning of this, because this is still on the February, so at the end we will see that what is the high end of the Industrial Revolution 4.0. So we start with the nanomaterials first, yes, it's good.
Of course, yeah. So this is the collaborator. This one, Professor Hadi Nur at UTM. When we visiting UTM with my research partner, and also Dr. Syahrul Nizam in USIM. So we can do the joint research, joint publication, and also invited speaker, keynote speaker. And here Professor Nora also as our keynote speaker back at 2016 and our international conference. And then Dr. Shima Saharun, when we visiting UTP, this one we do already the joint research and also joint publication. And on July 2021, there will be collaboration between UTP and also UM in ESCON annual conference, ESCON that we held by UTP. And this one with Professor Timotius Pasang at AUT New Zealand when I visiting him and also doing the characterization there. And this one when Professor Tim Pasang having a guest lecture in our university. So he came to Indonesia and having several guest lecture in university in East Java. So last but not least, all the research that we conduct is helped by this gentleman that great our bachelor and master student is really helpful, and they do many research under our lab and also under our funding, our project. And this gentleman and ladies here is my research assistant, have helped me so much on my research and my achievement by this years. And also this one, Mrs. Avita, in the student who is done in the mini heat exchanger project. So I think that's all, Mrs. Azliza. Thank you. And this one is a surprise for you when I visit university. I'm meeting the same picture in University of Malang with you, Mrs. Azliza.
Yes, it's great. You have the Masa University logo there. Okay, thank you. Actually, thank you, Associate Prof. Dr. Poppy Buspitasari for the enlightening and entertaining presentation for the nanomaterials for renewable energy. Okay, so actually that right now, if you see from your slide, we know that they have a lot of applications, okay, what we are using for the nanomaterials. So right now we are open for the Q&A. Okay, so we will see from the comments. All right, we have Okay, so we have a comment that we will answer after this webinar series. Okay, so actually, before we finish our session, I would like to thanks to Associate Prof. Dr. Poby Puspitasari for your time, everything, and your effort for the nano materials. That hope that we will have a collaboration, and also we have another series with you, Prof. For
my honor.
If we want to go, what is the current demand right now? Which is that what is we go for the COVID-19? All right. So
yes.
And also, I would like to thank you to everyone. Okay, for those watching this webinar series, and then hope you getting a lot of input from Prof. Poby in our session today. Stay safe and bye bye.